Hey, Vinyl Community, this is going to be another installment in my 10 in 4 series where I give my top 10 songs for a band in 4 minutes. Today, by request, I'm going to do my top 10 Rolling Stones. So let's get started. Number 10, Tumbling Dice. Just love that sleazy little rocker. It's not in a hurry to get anywhere. You got Charlie Watts holding that lazy rhythm down. You got that great guitar interplay between Keith Richards and Mick Taylor that makes it all work. Number 9, Angie, my favorite. Probably the best ballad the Stones ever did. Definitely one of their classic tracks. It's off Goat's Head Soup. Nobody quite has ever settled on who Angie is, but it's just a tender, very melodic ballad. Number 8, Paint It Black, one of my favorite 60s psychedelic rockers from the Rolling Stones. It's been in so many movie soundtracks, and it's one of my favorites. It's a lead-off track off their Aftermath album. I love the rhythm, the sitar. Brian Jones was such a crucial element to the Rolling Stones sound in the late 60s. Number 7, for the same reason, Under My Thumb. Love that marimba that Brian Jones added to this track. You got Mick Jagger just with such a sneering kind of attitude, just contempt for the person that he's in a relationship with. And it just works. It's a great rocker. I love the way that they redid it live in their 1969 tour, but one of my favorites. Number 6, going to my favorite Rolling Stones album of all time, Let It Bleed for Monkey Man. 90% of the reason why I like this track is because of Nicky Hopkins' piano intro. It's a sleazy track about drugs, but it's got a great rhythm to it. I love the piano all the way through. I love the way Mick Jagger sings it. Just a classic. Number 5, Jumpin' Jack Flash, one of their greatest late 60s singles. Just a great rhythm, a great memorable Keith Richards guitar riff. You got a classic Mick Jagger's vocal and it all works. Number 4, back to Let It Bleed for the lead off track, Gimme Shelter. And Keith Richards wrote this track because Mick Jagger was seducing his girlfriend on the set of their movie. I think it was Ned Kelly. And so he went back to his hotel room and wrote this apocalyptic rocker. But it is great. That whole falsetto ooing that Mick Jagger does at the beginning just totally sells the song and gives it that ominous tone. Number 3, Can't You Hear Me Knockin', my favorite track off Sticky Fingers. I love it's a straight ahead rocker to begin with, and then it does that little break, and then all of a sudden it's the Rolling Stones doing Santana, but it is so beautiful, so gorgeous, and a great track. Number 2, You Can't Always Get What You Want. Now, I love the whole choral opening. You got the boys choir singing that opening. Then you got the gentle acoustic intro, the little bit of brass there, and then Mick Jagger singing his drugged out lyrics again. And then it just builds to that crescendo. Charlie Watts beating the hell out of the drums at the end, and then the choir swells. Everything at once builds into that magnificent crescendo. It is amazing. And number 1, going to the Beggar's Banquet album for Sympathy for the Devil. Just an evil track. They started the whole satanic rock, and it's okay to sing about Satan and the dark side of spirituality or whatever you want to call it. And it's not so much that they're advocating Satanism. It's just the whole idea that how much Satan is taking credit for the events in our history, which is just a clever lyric. And I love in the movie Sympathy for the Devil, where you get to see it kind of built up in the studio. So that's my list. Hope you've enjoyed it. Maybe you agree, maybe not, but in any event, take care.